Right now, it is a walk to remember in downtown Asheville.
That's right. The annual walk to end Alzheimer's is this Saturday at Peck Square Park. Here to tell us more is Jenny Presley. She, of course, is the development manager of the Alzheimer's Association of Western North Carolina. Good morning. Thank you for coming. How big a problem is this disease?
It's a huge problem, Jay. And we have over 5 million people with the disease. And in North Carolina alone, we have 170,000 people with the disease, which would fill up the Panther Stadium and the Dean Dome.
Wow. So how does Saturday's event help?
Well, Saturday's event is raising money both for awareness and research and services here in the 17 counties of Western North Carolina.
Okay. This is an annual event.
Mm-hmm.
How is the response?
It's really been a very positive response. We are already past our goals from last year, so we're heading towards our new goal of $85,000 this year. We have more teams registered so far, so we're really excited about Saturday.
Okay.
Now, that's a remarkable amount of money, and you and I were talking earlier this week. Part of that money is, of course, used for research.
Right.
The other part, though, for patient services. Explain that.
Well, there's what we can do here in Western North Carolina is we have a program manager who helps out with one-on-one care consultations. We have a 24/7 helpline that anybody can call any time of day and get a live person. It's 1-800-272-3900. And we train support group facilitators, and we have materials and things like that that we just do what we can to help the people here in Western North Carolina.
I'm curious, what are these? They're very cool.
They are very cool. Those are our Promise Garden flowers. Everybody who comes to the walk gets one, and the colors represent something. The yellow one that you're holding right now is for caregivers. The orange one is for people who envision a world without Alzheimer's. The purple one is for somebody who has lost someone to Alzheimer's, and the blue one is for somebody with the disease.
Wow. And you talk about the caregivers in particular.
Mm-hmm.
This disease is especially hard on them.
It really is. Mm-hmm. Caregiving is a 24/7 job, and it really wears you out. And a lot of times people have to quit their jobs to take care of their loved ones, so they lose their income. There's just not really the money there to help people out with that part of Alzheimer's disease.
All right, we'll talk more about all this coming up in the next hour.
And again, for all the information for Saturday's walk, go to our website, WLOS.com. We will link you there. Registration 9 a.m., walk at 10 a.m. Please go out if you can and help. We'll be right back. Stay with us. September is World Alzheimer's Month, and an event to help raise awareness and help end the disease is happening this weekend in downtown Asheville.
It certainly is. Joining us live right now, Jenny Presley, to talk to us about the walk to end Alzheimer's. Good morning to you. Quite the goal this year.
Yes, $85,000. Last year our goal was $65,000. We made it, and this year so far we've raised over $55,000, so we're well on our way.
Wow. So how can folks get involved to help you reach that $85,000?
Well, they can go online to alz.org and sign up. They can just show up at 9 o'clock Saturday morning at Peck Square. They can contribute. They can do almost anything, including going to your local Walgreens and buying one of these flowers. A lot of our teams are selling these flowers as well.
Okay.
And bracelets, too. They're each $1 a piece, and all proceeds go to Alzheimer's.
So we can get these at any Walgreens?
Uh-huh, you sure can.
Okay.
So if you can't make the walk, a great way to still make a big contribution.
Exactly.
All right, this is a terrible disease.
Mm-hmm, it
is. It's going to affect 1 in 6 people.
Mm-hmm.
And 5.4 million Americans living with it.
That's exactly right. And here in North Carolina, it's 170,000 people. And if you really want a visual for that, you would need the Carolina Panther Stadium as well as the Dean Dome to fill them up.
So this is going to touch pretty much everybody in some way, shape, or form.
Exactly. Almost everybody here has been touched by Alzheimer's, which is why we have our Promise Garden flowers.
Okay.
Each flower indicates your connection to the disease. Purple, you've lost somebody. Yellow is a caregiver. Blue, you have the disease. And orange is you envision a world without Alzheimer's.
Oh, wow. These are really cool.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, you can take them home and plant them at home after the walk, and every single participant gets one. It doesn't even matter if you've raised any money or made a donation, and they spin around. They're really nice, and they're durable. They last all winter long.
And it really is a reminder of just how crippling this disease is, how devastating it is, frustrating.
Mm-hmm.
For
yes.
Researchers as well, but caregivers especially have it difficult, right?
They really do. It's a 24/7 job, and it's just it wears you down. A lot of times people have to quit their job to take care of their loved ones, so they've lost their income. There's not really a lot out there to help with taking care of your loved one and giving you a break from that.
Okay, so folks can get involved by heading out Saturday
to
go to the walk. Lots of people are going to be out there, hopefully filling Peck Square Park. Registration's at 9 a.m. The walk, of course, starts at 10 a.m. Hopefully Julie's going to have some fantastic weather to get folks out and about. And again, if you cannot make it to the walk, head out to Walgreens. Go ahead and buy a flower. Just a $1 donation. Every little bit helps.
And I love that Julie's wearing purple, too.
And Julie is wearing purple today.
Thanks so much.
Yes, thank you.
Again, for more information, go to our website, WLOS.com. We'll be right back.